Welcome to another episode. Today we have a really fantastic event that I was going to do, a tasting of two limited editions tequila. So what we have first is we have the Don Julio. There's a limited edition Primavera. I'm pretty sure I'm pronouncing that incorrectly. This is Don Julio that's 100% agave, rested in orange wine cask for a light citrus finish. And then this all really spurred because I got my hands on this bottle for Fortaleza Reposado. This is the limited edition winter blend that comes out once a year. I know nothing about this. I heard and got my hands on one. This is like the supposedly most get bottle in tequila, most prize. They do winter blend releases, which they second aged it. And this is for 2021. I think they started in 2019 and 2020. 2020 they did some beer, aging some beer casks, I believe. So I thought this beer excellent because it's both wine casks. And this was extra aged American and French oak ex Marsala wine casks. So look forward to it. So how about we just get started? So this is Don Julio, 1942. And I looked online a little bit just to get some more information on this. And just a little interesting fact, Don Julio, one of the higher end ones in 1942, and that's when actually the distillery started. The gentleman got a loan when he was like 17 years old. Interesting story. They only started making this in, I believe, 2002. Let me just double check my notes. Yeah, 2002, 1942 in general, not I'm saying this bottle, is usually aged in small batch and aged for a minimum of 2.5 years. So this is, I think, technically would be an Añejo, I would guess then. Yeah. They were one of, what they prized themselves for on the website marketing is that they choose quality over quantity. What they did was they allow the agave plants to grow further from each other and fully mature before they harvest. So that's kind of their how they differ from each other. And they say they only select the most succulent portion of the pina before steaming them for 72 hours. So that's their story. Thought that was a little fun fact. And Fortaleza, I didn't have to do much research. Well, they have a lot of information on their website. It's one of the oldest tequila distillery, and they still do stuff very old school. So I guess that's kind of the highlights. I noticed they have some information in the back. But price point, I believe they are super similar also. Don Julio, I believe it's about 120 to 160. I think I grabbed it for 120. This is a little bit more expensive. I think this was 150. So that's that. Nice cork. Wow, really, really gotta be careful. I don't wanna break the cork. Wow, really big cork. Wow, one of the biggest cork I've seen. Wow. Maybe deep. Doesn't hit you in the face like other tequilas. So this is bottle 519. Limited to 11,649 bottles worldwide. So supposedly not that much. I believe my local store got 3. And I got 1. So that's that. So, how about we just get started with the nose? Start with the Don Julio. I have, had this before. It's been sitting. I was kind of debating what to compare with. So, I found something that's similar that's double age. So, immediate nose. Off the bat, cat of spice, honey agave, a lot of honey, light honey. And what you really get is the orange citrus, which I guess makes sense because it's being aged in orange wine cask that have held orange peels. And they say it gives it a balance of citric and honey. It's funny that on the website, when you look this up, they actually give like a lot of recipes to mix it. I don't think I will ever mix, I guess I haven't ever mixed any tequila over $100, but yeah. I found that interesting. That you can sip, they encourage you to make mixed drinks with it. So, spice, honey, maybe a lot of honey, citrus notes of orange, like orange peel. Easy, balanced nose. No, don't have to work too hard. Interesting nose. Okay, let's go to the Fortaleza. I'm pretty sure I'm pronouncing that incorrectly. This is I never drank this brand before. Supposedly very high price, I got educated in the store. Wow, totally different nose. More complex. So this is a more simple, elegant nose. This is very interesting nose for tequila. I did not get a nose of tequila at all. All right, let me start. I just want to take my time. I get herb. Front end, a touch of vanilla, a sweetness, but really what it's like 70% is the herbal nose, which I don't get a lot. I get a little freshness. Really gotta take time with this. A little citrus at the back end. I would say lemon citrus. Yeah, so I'll say vanilla, it really was powering it. It's an herbal nose. I don't know how to best describe it. Some citrus there. So that's that. All right, let me go to the tasting notes. So I had this before, and if I remember correctly, I remember being quite thin, but very easy to drink. Okay. Wow, honey, a lot of honey. Honey, not in a bad way bad, but gives a nice sweetness in tequila that I usually don't get. No sweetness. Very light, super, super light. This is it's a great summer drink. You know, be outside, barbecue, put over ice. I wouldn't put it over ice though. I think it's too thin. I think the water will just dilute it completely and lose the complexity. It's very delicate, this tequila. Okay, honey agave, touch of spice. I'll say like 2 to 3 out of 10 in a good way. I usually don't like spice, but this is balanced spice. And then at the back end, you get that spice, you get a little bit of burn. Nothing like you can't tolerate it, tequila burn. with a little, the finish is like citrusy. So, very easy to drink. I wish it was, I think the ABV is low. It's 40%, right? And I think it shows, you can immediately tell it's a little, it feels a little watered down. I would love to see this at a higher proof. Maybe 50%, 40, 44%. Yeah. Good legs though. Look at that. I don't know if you can see that. Colors. You can see from the bottom, it's more orangey. I don't know if they add any coloring or not. Probably not. Good tequila. I would love to drink this. A little bit expensive though. I think the MSRP is what, 120 I have written down. It's a lot of money for tequila. A lot of money. All right, so let me see Fortaleza. Notice now in the back, on they say, they give a description. So say silky start of sweet agave balanced with a nose of dry masala wine with a subtle finish of baking spice and hints of butter, vanilla, clove, nuts, and citrus. Oh, I never got butter in anything before, so let me see if I get some of those notes. Okay, nosing it again. Very complex nose. You can sit here and nose this. Yeah, a lot of herb and a touch of sweetness. Okay, I'm just seeing if they have any nose notes, and they do not. Okay, maybe light. The color is a lot lighter, as you can see from the bottle, but super light. Super light. Like almost clear with a tint of orange, of a tint of brown. Like, if you pour this, you might even think it's vodka or something. I know vodka's clear, but it's that clear. Good legs, not as much. So, I have some things written down. So this is open air fermented wood tanks, nature's character, while the ancient Tohono real crushing process in rarity. So I guess they crushed it naturally. Twice distilled in copper pot still, then aged 6 months in American oak, that's the first finish, and then 10 months in French oak. Wow, 6 months. So 6 months in American oak, 10 months in French oak, and then finish in a previously used Masala wine cask. Let's say gives it is baking spice, butter, vanilla clove, which is the description in the back. Yeah, I think that one, they are the one of the oldest distillery making tequila. So on the website, it gives like 7 things why they differentiate their tequila. It's their agave. They grow it for at least 8 years. They cook it, slow cook it for 36 hours in old stone ovens that they still do to today. They do 100% stone crush, which is using a 2-ton volcanic stone. That's interesting, I guess. Fermentation in wood air tanks, like we said, using a special yeast. They're aging in, you know, like I said before, and the bottles are hand blown. What I learned also is, Don Hill's website, is that tequila bottles is usually tall, but when they made the regular tequila, they made it short, so they kind of broke the tradition on that. But this, you see, they made it tall. Alright, I'm excited to try this. Okay. Wow. Very interesting. Wow. Zilburn. Like 2%. Very complex. Very complex. I think I need to spend a little bit more time. Let me go in again. First is I feel its age. Oak presence is definitely there. Very oak. Very, very oak. Oak, vanilla, citrus, little bit of cinnamon, very rich, spicy, not in a bad way of spice. I don't like spice, as you may know. Tad, very elegantly done. So, it's more vicious. I like the feel of this more, and I think this is barrel proof, I believe. This is 46.3 cask proof, is what they say. 46.3, and it shows. You know, spirits are just better delivered at a higher proof. Oh, this is nice. This is really nice. Cask, let me see, they have a little thing here. So let me see what this, they have a couple. Let me see what they have here. Saying that they make great tequila. We cook all our Weber blue agave in brick ovens, copper pots. Again, 6 months for American oak barrels and use former Sicilian. Oh, they didn't say that on the website. Marcella wine barrels of French oak blend together. Undiluted, we blend and bottle it at 46.3. So it comes out. Cash strength. Our familia is very proud that we have accomplished and hope you enjoy. We also invite you to visit us in Tequila. In Jalisco, Mexico? Yeah. I'm pretty sure I'm pronouncing that incorrectly, so I apologize. Very good Reposado. I don't like Reposado. I like Alejo's better. And this is, wow, I gotta get their standard grade. They don't make a lot of tequilas, different ranges, so supposedly they make a few. I think one. They just make a Reposado. Maybe they make a Añejo too. I have to check on that. But no, oh, this is fine. Okay, drinking again. Wow. Sweetness, little pepper. First time I like a pepper taste like this. Age, you can feel its age. Very creamy. Does it say on here? No, it doesn't say creamy. Let's say it again. Silky start. It is silky. Sweet agave. Subtle finish of an essence of bacon spice butter. Oh yeah, I'm trying to see if I get the butter taste. Maybe borderline. If I didn't read it, I don't think I would pick it up. Definitely pick up the clove, citrus, vanilla. Maybe a little bit of nuttiness when it dries up. Definitely a lot more complex. So I guess that's where you have it. You know what? Let me make this interesting. We have revealed. You see that that's another Reposado bottle. I know last time when you said what kind of tequila I have, and I only have Patron. That is not true. I do have a few tequila, not a lot. Mezcal. But let's try against three. And the reason why I'm doing this is I'm trying to justify its price point. I think this is $30-something. This is $150. This is $120. Does it justify paying $150 for tequila? And I'm kind of curious. You better have 5 bottles of this or 1 bottle of that. I guess that's the answer. A little bit more. Very creamy, rich on that. Ooh, very long. Long finish. This is very short. Before I move into this, I just want to give a summary. Great nose, citrus, orange, good for a cocktail. Like, I would make this for an old fashioned. I wonder how it tastes like. Never made old fashioned tequila before. But very thin, easy to drink. This is like, I would say, the blue label of tequila. You know, Johnny Walker. I think you give this to most people, they would love it. Except if they don't drink tequila, they would love that. But this, the Fortaleza, the nose, I usually don't like that herbal, but it's interesting. I could sit here and gain to like it. I could sit with this glass for longer, and I don't have that much left in here. Good nose, deep, rich. Yeah, no, very interesting tequila. You could taste, I feel like you could taste the sweat and tears of the people making this tequila. Very complex. Okay, so let me try this. I remember I liked this. If I remember correctly, I score a high 70s, low 80, or 80. I think it's like 78 to 80, but I never give it an official score. Wow. Night and day difference. I think this two are more similar to each other, but wow. I would say 10 times different. You know, you never notice look at the color. The color actually is almost identical, but the colors are identical. The legs, you know, pretty much identical, not much legs, but the taste, the nose is, this nose is not as deep and strong as this. This, you gotta really work on it to pick it up. I guess it has that herbal note too. That's similar. Wow. Very rich, deep, a little bit of smoke. I love it. I need to go find another bottle. Okay. Best way to describe it, this is very one-dimensional. This is like 10-dimensional. It's like, this is good. It's great for $30. I will buy it. Simple, straight. Not as complex. Easy to drink. What's the ABV? 40%. Wow, this is 46%. And it drinks easier than this. Okay, so I think you have it. I think you could tell. Just hands-on. Probably the best reposado I ever had in my life. Yeah, what am I gonna score it? This is hard. High 80s, low 90s. Let me see my star stick with this. Oof, get the burn. Oof. Feel it. Oh, I get 78 for this. What's up, sum up? I don't know what I said. It is what it is. Watch it. I'm gonna watch it myself to see what score I gave. I forgot already. This, so what would I buy each bottle for each occasion? This is a great tequila. If someone that doesn't drink tequila that much, nice summer days, easy to drink, you know. I mean, if I come to your house and you serve me this, I'll love it. It's just hard to pay $100-something for it. And it's limited. I don't know if they make it anymore. Or it's an annual release or whatnot. But it's great. It's just a little bit expensive. I would love to see this in the 60 to 80 price point. You know? So, you know, if, you know, try it. Try it at the bar first. If you buy it, just know that's a little thin. I wish the ABV was higher. Easy to drink. You know, I will try to make a cocktail with it. You know, there you have it. I'll make a cocktail with it and see how it's like. This, oh my God. You gotta go find a bottle. You have to. There's, how many bottles? 11,000 bottles globally. And what I learned, I believe, is they're not ever gonna make this again. So people buy it, store it away, and it just goes up in value. You wanna collect it. But please don't. Buy your bottles and drink it. You know, open with friends and family, have some good conversation. Do a blind tasting test. I'm gonna do this with some of my friends. Great. Definitely go grab a bottle. If you see it, buy it for 100-ish. Supposedly, a lot of stores sell a lot higher than that. I might even pay up to 250, 300 for it. You know, just because, you know, I know I will never see it again if I miss it. Great bottle. Great. This, of course, you gotta have it around your house. That's for every day. Versatile. So, these two, definitely get this. Try at a bar, or if you have the funds to, you know, get it. This is a good bottle. It's just a little bit expensive, I think. A little thin. So there you have it. That's a reveal. I hope that was fun. Not every day I reveal limited edition tequilas, and tequila don't have that many limited editions. So I thought that was a fun reveal. I hope this information was helpful and you enjoy it. So thank you and have a great night.